Hey, hello guys, I'm back again with another video, and this is slightly off topic because in this video I'll be talking about Google Books, Google Play credits and migration stuff. So the idea for this video struck while I was migrating my Google stuff from one account to another. The problem was I had for lack of a better word, let's just call it a very childish Google email ID, which I created back in my college days. And with time, as I explored more Google services, that email ID got associated everywhere, from my YouTube handle to Google Pay UPI address, you know. And I'm sure this has happened to many of us. And now that I am mature enough to have an adult and ultra sophisticated email ID, I decided to create one. And also, I need to migrate all of my digital assets from my old Google ID to this new and mature Google account. So Google as a company don't want to be a prison for anyone, and they make it fairly easy to migrate your stuff. And Google has a dedicated portal for this, which is called Google Takeout, from where you can download your mails, your contacts, Google Drive files, photos, tasks, pretty much everything, your entire Google profile in an XML or JSON format, which can be later imported into a different Google account or maybe some other email service provider, and you'll be good to start a new life. While in some cases it is not possible to pack and move everything, you will have to leave your subscriptions behind, like you have any Google reward balance, any Google Pay credits, Google Play music files, and your Google Books. While there is no legitimate way to transfer Google Play credits and Google rewards balance to another account, but if you wish to spend it on books, I can show you how you can download your ebooks from one Google Books library and transfer it to another account. Okay, so now that we are ready to start the exercise, we'll quickly open Google Chrome in incognito window, just to open two different Gmail accounts in one PC. And I'll log in with my old Gmail account, which is silly name something something at gmail.com, and I'll provide my password and click next to login. Alright, so I have logged in with my old Gmail ID, which you can clearly see here. And after doing this, we'll go to my library, and I'll click on my books on Google Play, which will show the entire collection which I'm having in Google Play library. So these are the books which I have purchased or uploaded into my library. So because I have a small balance in my Google Play credits, I'll use that balance to make a new purchase. For this, we'll go to my wishlist, and let's just choose this first book. The book is titled The Law of Success by Napoleon Hill. Just click on the cover page, it will open the description, and from here you can see the title, the author name, the publisher. I can also choose to download a free sample without paying anything, but let's just click on buy, and as soon as I click on that button, another pop-up window appears which shows the book costs 29 rupees and I have that exact amount in my Google Play credits. I'll click on pay, and it'll ask for my credentials because this is a financial transaction, big or small, whatever it is. So once I provide my password, the purchase is confirmed. And we have successfully purchased this book, The Law of Success by Napoleon Hill. It has been added to our account and we can read it now if we want. Let's just refresh the page, and we can see the book is added to our library. It is present in one of the shelves among other books. And if I click to my purchases, I'll be able to see all the other books which I have purchased, and this book is also present there. So for this demonstration, we'll just download it in EPUB format. Go to this gear menu and click on download button, it will start the download. And we'll close the browser, go to our download location. So here in download folder, you can see I have downloaded some other books as well, but for now let's just focus on this recent download. I cannot open it right now because there is no program associated to open these kind of files. And if I go to properties, you will also see the extension of the file is ACSM, which is not what we choose while we downloaded it from Google Books. So anyway, let's just open the browser and go to books.google.com. And this time I'll log in with my new and sophisticated mature Gmail ID. So this is my mature Gmail ID, which I have logged in with. And I'll go to my library and click on my books on Google Play. You can see I have some other books which I have earlier purchased with this ID. But for now, let's just click on upload button, which will open another pop-up window. And from here, we'll choose downloads folder where we have downloaded the Law of Success. And we'll try to upload it, but here's an error. Now this error doesn't have any description why it failed to upload, but with our common sense we know, because it was a different format. Google Books only allows EPUB formats, and the book which we were trying to upload was ACSM. So there's a program which is called Adobe Digital Edition. Now this is a free software which is available from Adobe website. You just go to this download link, and from this web page it opens. You just need to choose your region if you want to and click on download. Now because I have already downloaded it, I just need to install the software. It's a small package of very small size, 8 MBs only, and once you double click it, we'll start the execution. Choose all the options and click next. It may take only seconds to install, and if any promotional offer comes like this one, just choose to click on no, and installation will complete. Just click close, and once you do that, you'll notice that all these ACSM files, they have been associated with Adobe Digital Edition software, because they now can be opened in this ebook reading software which we have now installed. And let me just show you the interface. Okay, so this is the ebook reading software by Adobe, and it gives us a sample book as well. We can open it. So this is what an ebook would look like in Adobe Digital Edition software. So let's try to open the book we downloaded, and we'll drag and drop or double click on this ACSM file. One thing I must tell you about this ACSM file, these are actually Adobe Content Message Server files. They only contain the metadata of the ebook, and when we open these ACSM files in Adobe Digital Edition software, it reads the metadata and then goes to the actual server locations from where it downloads the ebook contents. Okay, so now our EPUB is downloaded and it has been opened in this Adobe Digital Edition software. We can browse through all the pages, and we can also change the text size, we can read contents. We can make some bookmarks though, but we cannot copy or print anything from here because all these books are write protected with the DRM. And I will talk about the DRMs in my next video. For now, let's just focus on the task in the hand. Because this book is now downloaded onto this computer, it must have been stored somewhere locally. And default storage location for Adobe Digital Editions is in your Documents folder. Then there must be a folder named My Digital Editions. If we open it, there's the file, The Law of Success in 16lessons.epub. If we open its properties, we'll see the file type is EPUB, the extension of the file is EPUB, and it is larger in size as well. We see same files on this location as they were in Adobe Digital Edition software interface. Let's just close it for now and open our Google Books interface. We'll click on upload. Now because we know Google Books supports EPUB formats only, and we have converted this file using Adobe Digital Editions into EPUB format, we'll drag and drop it here. It will take few seconds to upload the book. And once the upload is finished, it will start processing and calibrating the book, its fonts and cover page and all the other stuff according to the Google Reader. Okay, so now the Law of Success is available in our Google Books library. Just double click on the cover page to open it. And everything seems nice and perfect. Here's the cover page. We can browse through pages. using this slider in the bottom, or you can also roll over the mouse wheel to surf through the pages. You can access the contents from here, and we also have the option to access bookmarks. Here we can change the font size, font alignment, and we can select the text, we can make some notes by selecting it. Pretty much everything which any book reader would allow. And these books in Google Library can be accessed from any Android device if you happen to have that Playbook app in your Android device. So this is how you can download your books from one Google account, convert them into EPUB, and then upload to a different Google Books library or to any other platform that supports EPUB. The procedure was plain and simple for normal books, but things get really complicated when there's a DRM embargo on documents. I have a solution to unlock that too, but it is a bit lengthy, so I decided to explain it in the next part of the video. Its link is now appearing on the upper right corner here. Do check it out. That was it. Like this video if you like it, or dislike if you disliked it, but press the subscribe button anyway. Goodbye for now, and I'll see you in the next video.